Alright, today I'm gonna try 4 different stunts in GTA 5 that I found on TikTok. I'm also gonna try something new today. I'm gonna track how many attempts each stunt takes. So once I've landed a stunt, we'll take a look at that number together. So let's get warmed up with this stunt right here by Dimbu G using the Ruffian. To sort of do this parkour jump between these two buildings and then just a small wall ride to this little precision stunt. Something simple to start us off in today's episode. And also, why not, let's do a timer for each stunt as well. Alright, starting off with this one. This one should be fairly simple. It's literally just this little gap, this little wall ride. Oh, we almost just got it. Oh, we almost just got the other one. Okay. Alright, so let's see. Probably won't be too many respawns on this one. Kind of just want to make sure that, yeah, the respawn program is working in the background. And of course, it's using the fast teleport mod here, which could add up, you know, because when you respawn like this, when you don't quite have enough speed, the respawns do add up. So it's not always a full attempt. It's more so a respawn before you land a stunt. Just like that. There we go. Alright, so that only took me, what, 50 seconds or so to land a warm-up stunt, so less than a minute. So ease my respawn key, and it took me 8 attempts to land the first stunt. But I do have a feeling that this next one is gonna be harder. So we're gonna be doing a scramjet stunt by Elite McBlonde. He's gonna be doing a clean jump up here. He throws in a front flip as well, and then lands a precision stunt with the scramjet on top of this skyscraper. On top of this, like, antenna thingy. Right, so I don't think I've done too many landings like that with the scramjet, but we do have the spawn point, so let's jump up. See how we do. I guess we'll try and do a front flip as well, because you can do a clean one without, like, getting any rolls. And yeah, you just need to land on top of that. That could get tricky. Oh yeah, let's start the timer. There we go. Now, we did do a scramjet stunt very recently, but it does still take a while to get the feeling down, unless we just hit this right here. Hey, I mean, we have the perfect lineup. It's legit all about the angle, and I'm gonna try and get as clean of a landing as I can on this one. And nope, we messed that up. Go back. It's actually kind of cool how the scramjet boost is exactly, like, it lasts exactly long enough so you can make it up to this little tower up here. It's a perfect spot for it. Now we do have another car stunt after this one, and then I actually did a BMX stunt, or I'm gonna try a BMX stunt, which, as you guys know, I don't do very often, but I found one that I think I can do, and, oh dude, that was really, really close. You just need to slam down. Land on top of this thing. Also, thank you guys for the great feedback on Apex Rush. I posted a new video on it before this one. Apex Rush is a racing game that I'm working on. And yeah, it's always fun reading all of your feedback and suggestions for the game. So I appreciate all the kind words. So go check that out in case you missed it. But oh, we're getting closer, kinda. Now that I know that you guys will see the attempts, I don't know if that's gonna make me try even harder to land the stunts, because obviously I want that to be as low as possible. Now, I could try and figure out a way to get the counter be on the screen as well, but I feel like it's more fun to get some of the reveal at the end, because you have no idea how many tries you do. And come on, let's get this. Come on. Flip. I think that's it. Maybe. Yes, look at that landing. Oh, the light went through the passenger seat. Luckily, nobody was sitting there. Yeah, we got it. Top of the tower, just like that. And that took 7.5 minutes. Okay, we're going through these stunts very quickly. Now, let's see how many attempts. Right, let's see. E36. You know what? I kind of expected more. But I guess it's a pretty long stunt compared to, like, bike stunts where you would respawn very close over and over again. Now, this next one is a BMX stunt, so this could be a lot of respawns. But here we have Perps using the BMX. You're gonna jump down into it, do a wall ride, and then fly out and get a grind on this billboard. And then I think it just jumps down, does some extra jumps at the end. But yeah, the grind is the main stunt. All right, so here it is. We did a pretty similar stunt not too long ago as well. But yeah, let's get the timer going. And let's see here. Let's respawn to our location. I think he did kind of a bend into it like that. And obviously, yeah, it's very tricky to get grip on the wall right sometimes. You need to land with, like, a perfect angle. That's not gonna work. I'm trying to do what I did last time. I'm using mouse and keyboard here as well. I think we get that. Yeah, there we go. That's the angle. Oh my god. Wait, that was actually really, really close. Ooh, I could have gotten a grind on this thing as well. I'm not sure if that's possible, though, because there's, like, barbed wire on it. At least we got the wall out once already. That's good. That is not what I want to do. Sometimes you just get stuck like that. It's so weird. I would love to know how the physics look like in the back end for BMXs in this game, because I think they handle so weird. Yeah, I think the hardest part here is when we make it to the grind, it's going to be difficult to actually do a grind and not just sort of bump off it. Because that tends to happen a lot as well. Okay, just a little 360 spin like that or something, and then just get the grind. There you go. That looked good. I think I need a bit more bit more angle, actually. Like that. Yes. I told you guys that I wanted to... Oh, wait. No. What? Get my bike. yeah, we cannot do a grind on the barbed wire. Confirmed. But yeah, I was gonna say, I told you guys that I was gonna do more BMX stunts before GTA 6 comes out. Even though the handling is probably gonna be way, way different, but... I've always been so bad at them. But I do like these, like, bigger jumps into grinds and stuff. When it gets too technical with, like, small jumps and transitions, my brain just can't handle it for some reason. I need to exit the building a bit earlier. Not quite getting the speed towards the grind. Oh, wait. Keep in the barbed wire, man. Oh, is that far enough? No, oh, I guess any billboard works as long as I get the grind on top of them. Make it. No, dude, that angle was literally perfect. Oh, we're down there somehow. That was such a good angle, though. No, why did I just land on it with a back tire, man? That was such a good jump. And entry was so clean, too. Ah, that was barely a grind. That was like a transition jump. That was pretty good, though. Oh, dude, we even did a flip right there, but still just bumped off it. I knew this one would be tricky, man. I thought maybe I'm a bit warmed up since the last one I did, but no. I'm also not sure why I'm going for 360 entries now for literally no reason but to make it harder for myself. There we go. I'll take that. With a 360 as well. Nice, dude. We finally got it. How many attempts could this be? I'm gonna guess 580 or something like that. That's probably way too much or way too low. I'm not sure. Hey, I wasn't too far off. Respawns total of 415 for this stunt. I also turned left and right like 3,000 times. I said I was pretty equal to his TikTok. So let's move on to the final stunt, which is gonna be a difficult car stunt. Let's see how many attempts we get here. So this one is by Hathku or Hathku, something like that. He's gonna be using the Dominator here to get this insane speed bump off this rock and then get a precision landing, kind of, I guess, or just landing on top of this building here by the industrial area. Not the cleanest landing. Let's see if we can get it better. All right, so here it is. I haven't really used this car too much, but yeah, we just gotta fly off here and make it to those rocks. So yeah, we need a lot of speed for this one. That's for sure. Good thing is, I only need to collect this speed once, because then I can just spawn back to it, just like this. Which is really, really good. Now, I think I need... Yeah, I need to go even faster than this to reach that rock. Okay, nope, we gotta stop, rewind, and go back. Oh, yeah. Start the timer. Can't forget that. Okay, this should be faster, and then let's disable it here. And, I mean, yeah, we'll need a lot of luck on this bump. Oh, boy, that's gonna be a hard jump to get. All the way over there. I mean, we can get some crazy random stunts on this one, I feel like. Yeah, I want to try this one. I've never really done a stunt like this, I feel like. I do like nose bumps, and this is kind of a nose bump, I guess. Okay, that was not too bad, actually. But yeah, I feel like I may have to get very lucky to make it up there. We'll see if I use any special ability on the landing. I'm gonna try not to. We're maxed out the speed here, I feel like, so it should be good. I think I just need to get the perfect bump now with the front. Oh, that looked good for a second, but then we hit the second rock there. Come on. No? Okay, not too bad. Oh, that bump was very good. Yeah, see, that was far enough, actually. Just need to make it up there. So yeah, for sure a bit of luck involved in this one, but obviously trying to aim for the rock that's like halfway submerged right there seems to give us the best angle. Oh, wow. Okay, that's very far. Imagine this tower. Wait. Special ability. Dude, we could have landed up there. Okay, there's a lot of random stunts, like I said. So, yeah, stay tuned. We might land something even crazier. Who knows? Oh, wow. That's really good. No, we just missed it. Just imagine if I land on top of the antenna. There's a similar one, like I landed on with a scramjet up there. Like one of those antenna towers. I'm not really sure what they're called, but... You guys know what I mean. This one? This one could be it. No special ability. Oh my god, we almost landed the precision thing there. Like, whatever that thing is, it's just... Like, I think my car would have fit up there. That was so close. Wow, that's really fast. That's too fast. Yeah, I'm not gonna use special ability to slow down that much. That was a good angle though. Only 8 minutes so far and we have had some very, very close calls on multiple landings. I should try some more stunts like this. Maybe one that's a bit more consistent. Oh, imagine up there. Yeah, I'm a big fan of nose bumps with cars, which is kind of what this is, I guess. Yes. I mean, I'm up here. I'm not going to count it because I slowed down to try and land up there. That's the only reason that I tapped special ability. Okay, this one ended up being difficult. It looked really good in the first, what, 10 minutes, 8 minutes when I almost made it up there. Was almost landing random stunts. Now it's just this. It's always too far. I've tried slowing down as well, but then I won't make it over the water. Hold on. No. Okay, what am I on? 41 minutes. Damn. This one ended up being a struggle. I keep going for just random stuff as well, which takes some time. I should just really only focus on getting up there, to be honest. Oh, come on. It's still too fast. We're closing in on an hour, boys. Oh, God. I mean, at least I saved this one for last, right? It's always nice to finish off with, I suppose, the hardest stunt. No, dude, I thought at least I could land a random stunt now. And we can't even make it up there, man. I just need to know that could be it. Yes, finally. Oh my god. Okay, 1 hour and 5 minutes. Almost 6 minutes. How many attempts is this? It has to be within like 700 something, right? All right, total was 679, so I was very, very close. Only 30 off. But here we have it. That was the last stunt for today. 4 stunts. Let me know what you guys thought of the attempt counter. Click over here to check out another video, and I'll catch you guys later. Take care.